If you're in Japan at New Year's, it's likely you'll be served a steaming bowl of osoni. This traditional good luck soup is made with vegetables, fish or meats, and a piece of glutinous rice. Each region has its own spin on the exact ingredients, but if you're in southern Japan, it's likely to include Nagasaki Chinese cabbage, known as tojina in the local dialect. Prevailing belief says the variety was brought from China, perhaps Shandong province, through the port of Nagasaki during the Edo period, between 1603 and 1868. After Portuguese traders began stopping there in the early 16th century, Nagasaki grew from a sleepy fishing village to a bustling port, and it was the only Japanese port open to foreign vessels and trade during the Edo period. Analyzing the Chinese characters used to write tojina suggests that it could have been introduced much earlier. The first character of the word refers specifically to the Tang Dynasty of China, which prevailed from the early 7th to the early 10th centuries. Tang civilization wielded tremendous influence on its neighbors. Japan adopted Tang governance structures and the Chinese writing system. It adapted Chinese customs and culture, and it embraced Buddhism, which had spread to China around the 1st century AD. Brassica rapas are thought to have arrived in China around this same time, helped along by Silk Road trade routes linking the East and the West. So it might not be a stretch to imagine that Nagasaki Chinese cabbage made its way across the East China Sea 1,000 years before the Tokugawa shogunate presided over a peaceful, though isolationist era between the early 17th and the mid-19th centuries. In any case, the tender, sweet, and juicy green became a treasured local specialty around Nagasaki on the island of Kyushu. According to the Slow Food Arc of Taste, different types of tojina were grown around the region. An early variety was cultivated near the mountains, and a late variety grown on the plains. While the early variety had to be harvested by December, late Nagasaki Chinese cabbage, with its large, deep, crinkled leaves and open heart, resists the cold and can be harvested well into winter. Both varieties are very tender, especially when young. The first leaves are often pickled, boiled for o-itashi, or used to make a frittata. This Brassica neurinosa has chromosomal cousins that may sound familiar, including pak choi, curled mustard, komatsuna, and tatsoi. Its susceptibility to crossbreeding, however, made protecting the integrity of Nagasaki Chinese cabbage a challenge. But farmers around Nagasaki have been carefully doing this for centuries, aided by the region's unique topography. Nagasaki farmers boast that the leaves have a unique flavor, one softer than ordinary Chinese cabbage. They are often used in simmered hot pot dishes, rice dumplings, and pickled for tsukemono, a staple use of Chinese cabbage. The finely chopped cabbage leaves are combined with cucumbers and carrots and then lacto-fermented for over 100 days, though recipes also abound for making quick pickled cabbage in a day or two. The salted yellowish pickles are a delicious complement to fried foods such as tonkatsu, as well as rice meatballs, or for a quick snack with steamed rice and tea. But changing tastes, an influence of the Western diet, and a decline in the number of growers emerged as a threat to this historically significant variety. Thankfully, seed savers and other heirloom vegetable enthusiasts are working to preserve it. For example, school lunchrooms in Nagasaki City serve traditional vegetables, including the Chinese cabbage, and a consortium of growers delivers fresh tojina to markets and shops around Nagasaki each day. As a nation of islands with limited land, Japan has always been a place of endless curation and adaptation, making all things uniquely Japanese. Nagasaki Chinese cabbage is no exception.
Thanks so much for watching Seed Stories.
We love bringing you the backstory on these amazing varieties. Be sure to click the subscribe button so you won't miss a single episode.